Tonight's DJ and TV show is sponsored in part by Electro Voice, DJ Event Planner, ADJ, NLFX Professional, Promo Only, Newmark, and DJ and TV Insiders.
If you're a part of a minority group and you are trying to break through in an industry that is overwhelmingly dominated by, well, not you, this is the video for you. This Ask Him a Question comes from a woman that feels like she's trying to break into a frickin' boys club. She says, "There seems to be all these rules that apply to me and not them. I'm finding it difficult to break through. What advice do you have for women trying to be visible in an industry that only sees you as a marketing ploy? How do I keep myself motivated when it feels like everything and everyone is against me?" Girl, I feel ya. I've been there. I feel like we're kind of always there, but we're finding different tools that help keep us motivated. So number one thing I'm gonna tell you that it's a big recommendation to do is to find your tribe. Find other women, non-binary, LGBTQ community of people that are trying to break through in an industry that maybe doesn't empathize with their experience, so that you can find people that can empathize with your experience, that will validate the issues that you're going through instead of dismissing them. Because just having that acknowledgement in the first place is really powerful. The second thing that's really huge to that is that you're gonna see other people breaking through regardless of adversity. People that strive to be bigger and better and continue to learn all they can about their craft, which is really important in building that confidence and refocusing your energy on something that's really important to you instead of letting all this other stuff bring you down. So if you can find your tribe, and you can find it in many different ways. You can find it sometimes groups within your city. Maybe it's different workshops and support groups. It can also be Facebook groups, non-binary, two-spirit, female identifying people in music, maybe within your own city, maybe within your own state or province or country or genre of music or industry specific that you are in. Maybe it's in wedding, maybe it's in corporate gigs, maybe it is in electronic music. The groups are out there, search for them. Number two, find inspiring women. Look for them and follow them. So maybe it's people within your industry that are doing way, way better than you. They're super successful. They're playing regular gigs. Those are the women that you want to follow and even subscribe so that they're highlighted. They're the first thing that pops up as soon as you go on Facebook or Twitter or Instagram. So you can see their stories. You can see how successful they are. And you can use that as motivation to say, yeah, that's where I want to be. That's what I want to be doing. And look, she's making it happen, and she's making it happen, and this person's making it happen. To have that constant reminder that it is possible is really important. And these people are going to be sharing a lot of their stories of adversity and how they have risen above it. Number three, be on the lookout for male advocates, because they are out there. They are people that are going to stand up for you, that are going to call people out on their behavior, and are going to support you. Now, with this being said, my big warning thing is to be wary of people that are trying to lift you up by putting other people down. So this is a big no-no. If somebody says to you that you are a better female DJ than another female DJ, they didn't get the memo on ethics, because that is not a compliment. Telling someone that they're better at something than someone else really, to me, is not a compliment. A compliment is being specific about something that someone's doing. Wow, I really love this mix. I love the journey that you brought me on. I love the fact you mixed in key, or you did this type of mixing. Be specific about the thing that they're doing, not comparing them to other people. Number four, throw yourself into your craft. Learn everything that you can. YouTube videos, books, workshops. Because when you learn, you build confidence. When you throw yourself into your passion and you practice, you are building confidence by getting better at this thing that you're super passionate about. Also, problem solving. You run into issues maybe when you're recording a mix or when you're making a tune or when you're trying to master something and you start realizing, I can figure this out. Oh, I have resources. I don't need somebody else to be here to hold my hand in order to do this thing. I can either teach myself as I go or I can look up some tutorial online and figure it out from there. It's another way to really build confidence by showing yourself that you can do something. I hope that you guys found this video helpful. A little story, since I was talking about be wary of people that try to compliment you by putting down other people. A few years back, I had a private message from a random profile that said that I was better than another woman in the industry. A woman that I had never even heard of, and she lived in my own city. I ended up checking out her music and loving it. And then I went back to that person to say, like, I don't know what you're talking about. This woman is phenomenal. And then I messaged her, made friends with her. This person had basically made the same comment to this woman, trying to peg us against each other. And we ended up creating a friendship. We ended up hanging out. We ended up working together musically for shows. And I just thought it was so funny that this person was trying to make two talented women not like each other within their own industry. And what does that really say? We don't want to see women working together. We don't want to see them succeed or get along. It's so ridiculous. And I think it's important that we are supporting and acknowledging and inspiring one another. And I feel like women, we don't have time for drama in male-dominated industries. Working together is such a wonderful resource, and it's very rare that I see that sort of drama between women. So I just want to remind you, when you hear things like this, don't automatically believe them, even if they are true. That person might be hearing the same kind of message and believing it and kind of going off of that. And they might not always feel like that, and they might feel horrible down the line. Regardless of that, it's important that you just focus in on your craft, that you remember what is important to you in the long run, and work with other like-minded individuals that support that. If you guys have any Ask Kimba questions, make sure you hashtag on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, or you can email me at beats@kilmamusic.com for all of your Ask Kilma needs. Something like that.